Bitcoin will soon go to $150,000. Let us explain. Everyone knows there are...
Hi guys, welcome to the tutorial. In the course of next few videos, we will learn how to create smooth 3D shots like this in easiest way possible. Let's get started. Let's start with a new composition. This time we want to keep the aspect ratio as 9:16. I'm just going to multiply this by 2. Same thing over here. And press on OK. For our reference, I'm just going to drag the demo video to a timeline. Let's get a background layer. Go to solid. Select the same color. Let's call it as BG. And press on OK. Perfect. In step 2, let's create the square. Go to the top. Let's select the square. Keep the fill as solid. Keep the color as black. Keep the stroke as none. Coming over here, ensure that no layer is selected. Create a square like this. Holding on shift, just drop it over here. Going to align, I'm just going to align it in the middle. Perfect. Let's call it as the square. Selecting the layer, search for 4 color gradient. Let's keep this as white. This one as white as well. Let's change this to a green tone. Perfect. Something like this. Let's add a keyframe over here on this point. Let's zoom in. Come to the start. Coming to 1 second. Let's move this point over here. At 2 seconds, let's move it somewhere over here. 3 seconds over here. And at 4 seconds, I'm just going to drop it on this side. Perfect. So if I play this, perfect. Now we have to animate the square. For that, press on S, add a keyframe in scale, go to 3.5 seconds, and let's scale it up from 100 to around 130. Let's select both of them and press F9. For step 4, let's create the curved line. Select the pen tool over here. Keep the fill as none. And keep the stroke as 2. Coming over here, make the first point. Let's make a curve like this. Perfect. I'm going to increase the stroke to around 5. Next, in order to animate it, select the layer. I'm just going to call it as a line. Go to the top in the add. Let's add the trim paths. Open this. Add a keyframe in end. Let's make this as 0. Go to 3 seconds. And let's change this to 100%. Oh, we forgot to do one thing. At the start, make sure that you parent this to the square. That way, as the square is expanding, the line will also increase along with it. Perfect. This is looking great. Now, let's quickly make the number counter. I'm going to close all the layers. Firstly, let's select our rectangle. Keep the fill as solid color. I'm going to change the color. Go to green. Keep it a green shade. Something like this. Keep the stroke as 0. In fact, we need the rounded rectangle. Coming over here, let's create it. Zooming in, let's open the rectangle. In the rectangle path, let's increase the roundness. We can keep it around 100. Perfect. Let's press on V. I'm going to call it as the rectangle BG. Next, we have to add a circle over here. Again, let's select the ellipse tool. Coming over here, let's create a circle like this. Keep the fill as black. Let's arrange it nicely over here. Go back to project. I have this Bitcoin logo over here. Let's drag it to a timeline. Press on S. Let's make this small. Press on R. We might need to rotate it a bit. Okay. Let's place it over here. Let's decrease the size. Maybe 2. Okay. This is looking great. We'll place it over here. I'm going to add a fill effect on top of it. Go over here. Go to yellow. Let's change to a light yellow color. Perfect. Now let's add the number over here. Go to text. Coming over here. Just write anything that you want for now. We'll change it in a bit. Let's increase the size though. Let's place it over here. We want this as a number counter. For that, selecting the layer, let's add the slider control, open a text, click on the source text, opening the effects, open a slider control. Now take this pickwick next to a source text and connect it to a slider control. You see immediately it turned into zero. Now coming to the start, at this point we want to start by around 55,000. Let's make it 55,000. Add a keyframe over here. Coming around 3 seconds or 3.5 seconds, let's change this to around 100k. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. So if I go back, we'll see it is changing from 55 to 100k. But we want this in a currency as well as with commas between it. For that, we'll need to add a simple expression. Coming over here, open this source text. Firstly, in inverted commas, let's add a dollar sign plus. We'll need to add a math expression. So let math dot floor. This one. Let's close one bracket. In the end, let's add the bracket dot to local string. This one. Let's close it. Immediately, we got a nice number counter. If you want a space over here between a dollar and a number, simply coming over here, you can add a space. Perfect. Let's close this. Then lastly, let's add the small circle over here. Going to the top. I'm just going to add the circle like this. Perfect. Let's change the color and keep it the same color like this. Now selecting all the layers, I'm going to right click over here, pre-compose, and let's call it as a number. Ensure that you select on move all attributes to a new composition. Press on OK. Let's zoom out a bit. Oh, I forgot to do one thing. Inside the number, the color of this should be black. Okay, let's get back. Perfect. I hope this is clear till now. By the way, if you want to take your skills to the next level and want to create insane animations like this, make sure to check out the link in the description and check the challenge today. Now, in step 6, we have to parent this number to the line so that it moves as the line is increasing. For that, go to line. From over here, search for path. See the path over here? Select the path. Go to Windows, scroll down. You will find the option Create Nulls from Path. Click on this. And next, simply click on Trace Path. That's it. Let's close it. Press on V. Go to the start. Click on this layer. I'm just going to call it as the line path. Let's press on U to see the keyframes over here. So right now you can see the keyframe is only from 0 to 1. So after every 1 second, it will keep on looping. So simply take this keyframe and keep this at 3 seconds. So at this point, it will be over here at the top. At the same time, when our line is over here as well. Perfect. In fact, you can press U over here. Selecting all the 4 keyframes, you can press on F9. Now we don't really want this path after 3 seconds. Selecting the path, press on option and the right square bracket. This will cut it. Now all we need to do is simply link this number to this line. Right now if I parent it to this line, see what happens. It will rotate like this. We don't really want that. Go to R, let's keep it as 0. Click on the number, press P. In position, we are going to add a simple expression. So click over here, just paste this. So it will be this com layer line path, basically the name of the path which you just created, dot transform dot position. Now if I play this, see, it will move along with the line. We'll arrange the position in a bit. But before that, if you go at the start, you want this to be outside the square. For that, take this track mat and connect it to this square. The square will vanish, but easily you can unhide it. Finally, click on this line path, go to the end, maybe at 3 seconds, go to anchor point, and let's adjust the anchor point. Maybe somewhere over here. I'm going to change the colors a bit. Perfect. So if I zoom in now, let's see where we can place it. Somewhere over here, right? So this way, if I play this, let's move on to the next step. Let's close all of the points. Now if I play this, see, we have got a beautiful animation the way we want. But there is one thing missing. If you see, even after 3 seconds, this keeps on looping. In order to avoid that, simply open our line path. Let's open the effects in trace path, in progress. Instead of this, let's paste this expression. I have provided this to you in the description. Basically, what we are telling After Effects is that after 3 seconds, just stop the animation. This way, you see, after 3 seconds, nothing really happens. Perfect. Now let's move on to the next step. In step 7, we are going to make all this vanish as well as turn this square into a circle. Somewhere at 3.5 seconds, we can start the change. Open the square, open contents, rectangle path, open the rectangle path. Over here, we have to change the roundness from 0. So over here, add a keyframe in roundness. At this point, change it to a circle. Select both the keyframes and press F9. Let's keep this one over here. Perfect. This looks great. Now we also need to add an exit trim path for a line as well as the animation for this text. Let's do it one by one. Selecting this, open the line up, open the contents and trim path. This time we have to animate the start property. At 4 seconds, it will be 100%. Add a keyframe. Going a little earlier, maybe at this point, let's make this at 0. Perfect. Let's select both the points. Press F9. I can even shift it a little over here so that it happens in a very fast way. Same thing with the number. Press on scale at 4 seconds. Add a keyframe in scale. I want to make this at 0. Little earlier, at the same point, let's make this back at 100%. So if I play this, perfect. Let's select both the keyframes. Press F9. Let's see the animation till this point. Perfect. Now let's add a text called as "Let us explain" and we'll turn this into a 3D. So again, selecting all, press on U to close them. Then select the text, click over here once and write the text "Let us explain". It's "Let us" is over here and "explain" is big, right? Okay. Let's place it over here in the middle. Let's change the color, keep it as white. Let me give it a little space. Ideally, this will come in maybe at 4 seconds. Maybe somewhere over here. Let's add a keyframe in scale. Add a keyframe over here. Here, it can be 100%. Going back, let's make this a 0. Okay, it's coming from this point. Go to your anchor point. Let's bring it over here in the middle. Perfect. Select both of them. Press F9. Now finally, let's turn this 3D. Right click over here. Go to new. Let's add a null object. I'm just going to call it as the controller. Make this as 3D. Turn this text layer as 3D as well. Parent it to our square. And turn the square layer as 3D. Make sure that you parent this square layer to our controller. This way, if I press on R, if I rotate this, see, perfect, right? This is rotating in the exact way that we want. So, this let us explain. At that time, you can start with the keyframes over here. At around 5 seconds, let's rotate it like this. So, let's see what we have created till this point.
Bitcoin will soon go to $150,000. Let us explain.
Perfect. After this, we have the animation of Bitcoin. We'll see this as well as the rest of the reel in the second part. So make sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you next time.